It's the Porter Wagoner Show, starring Porter Wagoner and the Wagon Masters with Speck Rhodes and Norma Jean, bringing you your favorite songs and stars of the Grand Ole Opry.
We're so glad to see you, and wondering how you've been. Everybody see the fun, let's
begin. Oh, and a great big howdy, and welcome to our show. It seems like it's been a week since we've seen y'all. I guess it has been, by the way. But we're awful glad you're with us, and we hope you'll enjoy the show. We're going to do one of the old folk songs for you right now, one called Jimmy Brown, the Newsboy. I sell the morning papers, sir. My name is Jimmy Brown. Everybody knows that I'm the newsboy of the town. You can hear me yelling, morning star, running along the street. I got no hat upon my head, no shoes upon my feet. I'm awful cold and hungry, sir, my clothes are mighty thin. I wonder about some place to place my daily bread to win. Time for our special guest today, and a boy that I have enjoyed working with many, many times on personal appearances, and he makes some real fine records for the Columbia Recording Company. Let's welcome him, Stonewall Jackson. Stone, we're awful glad to have you with us.
Very nice to be here, Porter. Always enjoy it. Doing the show. You know, I look like a piece of furniture around here. I'm all the time trying to con you into letting me come out here every chance I get. I really enjoy it, man.
Well, we enjoy having you, man. Every and time you always right in.
Every time
people.
You look around, there I am.
Do us a good song. You got a new record that we want you to do a little later on. It's one of your best, I think. But
thank
this one done good.
Thank you. Just pull up for it.
Water,
water, water, water,
Thank you,
boy. That's a wonderful song. That's one then you can just clap your hands and pass your feet all the way
Thank
through.
You ever so much. I always enjoy doing that one. It kind of gives me a chance to scratch that itchy foot.
Let's watch this good mix.
All righty, we'll do it together.
Fine job. That's Mac and Buck and all the Wagon Masters and the Black Mountain Rags. Real good ones. Now it's time for the pretty little lady that it's always a pleasure for me to introduce. She gets more popular every day. Let's welcome her out to our show right now. Pretty Miss Norma Jean. Here she is.
This is a tune that I still get more requests for than any that we do. One called Let's Go All the Way.
Thank you, Miss Norma Jean. That's a real pretty song. That's the one that kind of got her started out in the business. Real good one. I'd like to do one for you now that kind of helped me get started in the business quite a long while ago. How many times have you heard someone say, if I had his money, I could do things my way? I was waiting in fortune and fame.
We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Miss Norma Jean's daughter. Her name is Roma Lynn, and she's such a pretty little thing, I thought you ought to like to see her. Let's see that look. Can you show us the look one time? Let's see that face when you have your picture made.
Oh, boy.
Do you know who's coming up next? Who? Beck. That's right. Let's watch you and see what he's doing.
Hello? Hello, Sadie? Oh, God, did you see that good-looking little girl? Hello. You plugged me up down the Greasy Miles filling station. I want to talk to Greasy a minute. He got my car. Hello, Greasy. Yeah, this is Speck. You about got my car fixed? Yeah, get it all cleaned up. I'm taking Sadie out to the drive-in movie. We're having a grand opening out there tonight. Yeah. Yeah, old Dan Milford's back in town. Yeah, I got a letter from him one time while he was in the Army. Yeah, he was stationed in Honolulu over in Hawaii. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he was telling me about some of the fine things. He said, I'm telling you, Speck, that Hawaiian island sure are pretty. He said, I visited the pineapple plantation. And he said, I ain't never seen nothing like that in Skunk Hollow. And the Diamond Head Lighthouse. And Pearl Harbor. I ain't never even thought about nothing like that in Skunk Hollow. And then he said, I went to a place where they had one of them hula girls. And she got on that grass skirt and got up on my table and done a dance. He said, boy, I never dreamed of nothing like that in Skunk Hollow. Yeah. Then he said, all of a sudden, that girl jumped down off of the table and sat on my lap and started kissing me. He said, men on that just like Skunk Hollow. Yeah, I guess so. Kissing is the same in any language. Yeah, he told me while he was over there, he had him a date with one of those hula girls. Yeah, he said he'd been there about 2 weeks and he got him a date with the hula girl one night. She wiggled out of it. The Milford boys are pretty smart kids, you know it. You take that little 12-year-old Johnny. Oh, gone, he's poorly good the other day. Well, his papa come home one evening from work, and Johnny whispered to him, he says, Papa, he said, if you'll give me a dollar, I'll tell you what Mama said to the milkman this morning. Well, see, Daddy kind of jerked the dollar out of his pocket and handed it to the kid and said, okay, Johnny. He said, now tell me what Mama said to the milkman this morning, what the milkman said to her. He backed off about 10 feet and said, he looked at Mama and said, hello there, Miss Milford. How many quarts this morning, please? Look, get the car polished up real good and don't leave any dirt inside of it because she's wearing a new dress. Okay, I'll see you at the bar. So long, Greasy.
That's a good job, Beck. You're good. I'd like to tell you folks about our program book this time. This is our Porter Wagoner Show Hits the Road volume, and this contains pictures of each one of us on the show, a lot of snapshots taken all over the country, and also the words to some of our most requested songs. So if you'd like to have one, you can send 50 cents to Porter Wagoner, Box 404, Nashville, Tennessee. That's Box 404 in Nashville. Thank you.
Thank you, Norma. I'm going to do one of the songs now that has the words to it in this book, and it's one of our most requested sacred songs. I hope you will enjoy it. If Jesus came to your house, what would you do? What would you do? If Jesus came to spend some time with you, if Jesus came to your house to spend a day or two, if he came unexpectedly, I wonder what you'd do. When you saw him coming, would you meet him at the door with arms outstretched in welcome to your heavenly visitor? Or would you need to change some things before you let him in? Like burn some magazines and put the Bible where they fit. Oh, I know you'd give your nicest room to such an honored guest. And all the food you would serve to him would be the very best. And you'd keep assuring him that you was glad to have him there. That serving him in your home was joy beyond compare. But what about your family conversation? Would it keep up its normal pace? Would you find it hard each meal, say a table grace? Would you be glad to have him meet your very closest friend? Or would you hope they stayed away till his visit ends? Would you be glad to have him stay forever on and on? Or would you sigh with great relief when finally he had gone? You know, it might be interesting to know the things you'd do if Jesus came in person to spend some time with you. What would you do? What would you do if Jesus came to spend some time with you? This is our good buddy Eddie Ware, who sang with Stonewall on Waterloo a while ago, and I didn't introduce him a while ago. Eddie, we're glad to have you with us, man.
I'm glad to be here.
Sing fine, real fine. And right now we're going to call our guest back out again, a fellow that is a favorite of everyone's, I think. Let's make him welcome again, Stonewall Jackson.
Yeah! Nice to be here, of course.
This guy has such an interesting history of how he came to Nashville, and most of you probably know about it. He just came up here on his own out of the cotton fields, wrote some great songs, and made some hit records in his big song.
Some of the boys was showing me a picture here a while back. I don't know where it came from, why they emptied a sack of cotton.
I've seen it, yeah. You bet. So, this is Stonewall's new record, and it's a real good one, too. I think you'll like it.
I would like to do this one. I'd like to do this one, no matter if it don't sell 10. I like it myself.
They march in lines. Protesters, one and all, they'd rather go to prison than to heed their country's call. Get out of here, get out of there, let's have an end to war. I'm glad they weren't around to say get out of Valley Forge. The minute men are turning in their graves, Washington and Jefferson are crying. What's happened to our pride since when the free Americans sold for the other side? Did we send food to Hitler's troops or praise the enemy? Did all our children die in vain defending liberty? The Minutemen are turning in their graves. Washington and Jefferson are crying. The minute men are turning in their graves. I can't condemn the man who feels that taking life is wrong, but I fail to understand the man that won't defend his home. Dear Lord, I've got one little prayer I pray in years to come. Don't ever let those kind of people serve in Washington. The Minutemen are turning in their graves. Washington and Jefferson are crying tears of shame. To see these men who'd rather live as slaves. The Minutemen are turning in their graves. Oh, the Minutemen are turning in their graves. Thank you.
Thank you. Isn't that great? Fine song, Stonewall. We got a little time left for our trio here. This is the number two trio of the Wagon Masters. Ike, Mike, and Spike. Come on up here, boys. Do us a little Columbus Stockade Blues.
Way down in Columbus, Georgia. Wanna be back in Tennessee.
down in Bubba's stocking. Friends, they turned their backs on me.
That's Mac, George, and Buck doing one called Columbus Stockade Blues. That's all of our time for this week. Thanks a million for joining us. And if you enjoyed yourself, be back next week at the same time. So long, everybody. See you next week.
This has been the Porter Wagoner Show, a half hour of good country music and fun, brought to you from the home of the Grand Ole Opry.